Hi, my name is Colt Correa, and I'm the COO of Intrepid Control Systems. And what we have here is a couple products that support relatively new 10BASE-T1S automotive Ethernet network. And 10BASE-T1S is a relatively new Ethernet type network that is built on a bus or multi-drop topology. And it's specifically designed to compete in cost and functionality with legacy networks such as CAN-FD and FlexRay. So this is Automotive Ethernet's entry into a bus or multi-drop topology type of network, which has big advantages over cost savings and cable savings, weight, and so forth. So the two products that we have on display here are the RAD-Meteor and the RAD-Comet. The RAD-Meteor is a small, low-cost device in a plastic enclosure that has a screen and some buttons. And essentially, we have one 10BASE-T1S network here coming in, and then USB up to a host computer. And then the USB on the host computer enumerates itself as a Ethernet NIC for the RAD-Meteor. And each button on the RAD-Meteor can put the PHY, the physical layer, the chip, into different test modes for 10BASE-T1S. Like, for example, this one is a test for time jitter. We have one for high impedance mode. We have one for droop test, and so forth. And you can download scripts into the device to transmit data. And the other product that we have, this is more of a professional network product, is the RAD-Comet. And the RAD-Comet, we have two CAN-FD networks, we have a 100BASE-T1 network, and then also a 10BASE-T1S network. So here it's the same, a 10BASE-T1S comes in on this connector, and then we have either USB or Ethernet, standard Ethernet, 100BASE-TX coming out to a host computer. And the USB also enumerates as a Ethernet NIC. And what we have here is our vehicle spy connected to the Comet that's measuring the automotive data, the automotive Ethernet traffic that the Meteor is transmitting to the Comet. The Comet's receiving the data and then displaying the data in our vehicle spy software. And the vehicle spy software here, we can see some status registers of the PHYs themselves. For example, is 10BASE-T1S PLCA active, which it is in this case, and then some other statuses, like is there a collision detect and so forth. So with these tools, these are the start of full family of tools for 10BASE-T1S. It's looking like 10BASE-T1S is going to be a dominant network in the near future. Many OEMs are picking it up, and it's something that everyone should know something about. And the two products, again, are the RAD-Meteor, RAD-Comet, and my name is Colt Correa, COO of Intrepid Control Systems, and I thank you for your time.